Hey guys, this video is for Virgo. And hopefully you enjoy my readings. Thank you guys for liking, thank you guys for subscribing. I know I'm doing this different, this video. This is the messages for Virgo regarding their love. What are the messages for Virgo? Ooh, guys, sorry. Would it be this one? So it's kind of funny because I just did a reading and almost the same cards are coming out. So hopefully they have significance to you. And this is the card that fell out of the deck, which is what I was just going to talk about, guys. Okay. So, my beautiful Virgo, it is a pretty good reading. I want to start off by saying that there is a lot of energy of reconciliation. And before I get into the reconciliation part, I want to start with what happened before the reconciliation. So, I feel like there was a third party interference with this person that is going to want to resurface. Now, this person you could have met when you were younger. You have a lot of memories with them. I feel like you've grown with that person, or you grew up with that person or something. And I feel like that person that's going to want to resurface, there was a separation of some kind. And that was due to a third party interference. I feel like it was a very big heartache for you. And it was something that was very hard to endure, and it was such a disappointment, and it was just overall over the top emotional for you. And it was hard for you to pull through, and it was shocking because I feel like this person could have just got up one day and said, hey, you know what? I'm gonna get up and I'm gonna go. And without any explanation, I feel like you were left without any explanation, not really sure what went wrong, or you know, if it was you, maybe you were left feeling that it was you and it really wasn't you. I feel tremendously like it's gonna be like a rebirth. That separation that you had, it gave you a chance to rebuild yourself. I kind of feel like one of those energies, like maybe that person might want to come back because they see you doing better. You had a chance to rebuild yourself. It was quite a distance of you guys being separated. I feel like three people involved in this separation. A birth of something new is coming your way. Possibly with this person that wants to re-enter, because I feel like you really did care about the person that wants to re-enter. This person from the past is going to want to come back and exchange feelings, exchange what is going on, and you know, want to get back to where they lost. I feel like they'll want to come back and want to talk to you and, you know, completely ignore the fact that they were gone for a while and that they hurt you. You know what I mean? It didn't work out the way they wanted it to work out. I feel like you had trouble sleeping. Maybe depression, sadness. It was such a hard time. You had such a hard time in the past contemplating the situations, trouble sleeping, anxieties. And you finally rebuilt yourself. And I feel like this person is going to want to re-enter. And that depression and sadness was due to the breakup. Because of that third party you were on, you couldn't believe what happened. I feel like even maybe the person could have walked away with a friend or somebody that you knew or something. But, I mean, although they're going to return, I feel like you're not looking at the situation clearly. You might feel like you're in a bind or you're stuck, or, you know, you're stagnant because it's like you did all this work and all this improvement and you had the chance to rebuild yourself. And this person's just going to want to come up out of the blue and say, hey, how are you? what's going on, you know, and talk to you like nothing. And that's going to be the problem, is that they're going to just want to talk to you. They're very, very stubborn. It took you a long, you know, that sadness that you had, it took you a long time to get out of it. But clear skies are on the horizon. So I feel like you came out of that rough patch and you're moving forward. You're looking the other direction. So although this person is might want to resurface, this person is very stubborn, and things have to be their way, very prideful. So when they do decide to come back, it's on their terms. But I feel like you're going to be past that, because it's going to be one of those situations where you went through so much to get over it that it's like, why would you want to go back to that? You know, it's focus on yourself and improving yourself, because I feel like you have to do a lot of work emotionally. With you being hurt and disappointed, I feel like that's all you see. Maybe a lot of you guys might feel like that's all that things love will ever be, and that's really not the case at all. Yes. So that person that is returning, that person can be a manipulator. They know how to manipulate you. They know what to do to get you in the position that they need. They know how to pull your strings. They know you so well, like the back of their hands. I feel like you're gonna, when they decide to come back, man, you're gonna be like, you're gonna have trouble sleeping. You had trouble sleeping already. Your anxieties are gonna start back up. Symptoms of how you were prior are gonna start coming again, because you're not looking at the situation clearly. This person has not changed. Yes, they're very an emotional person. Maybe they could be even like moody, you know what I mean? Like their personality, one day they're okay, the next day they're not. And it's gonna affect you again. It's gonna make, you're not gonna know what to do. You're gonna feel stagnant, like stuck, and what you should do, because you're not gonna know what the next direction is to take. But don't let that person come back and manipulate you, because I feel like you're stronger than that and you're more than that. And everything that you work on, you don't wanna throw it down the drain. Don't isolate yourself either when it comes to love, because I feel like a lot of you guys might isolate yourselves in regards to love, because you don't want to get hurt again. You feel like hopeless in love because somebody threw you out in the past. Or maybe a lot of you guys might not have worked out because of the financial position that you were in at that time, or that person as well. I feel like somebody could have possibly got thrown out due to financial a situation. Maybe you're not financially stable, or that person isn't financially stable as well. So that is one of the reasons why the relationship didn't work out at that point. But a rebirth is coming your way. You did rebuild yourself. It was a chance to rebuild yourself from the ground up and get whatever it is that you didn't have at that time when you were together with that person, to establish yourself, okay? Take care of yourself is my biggest message, because I feel like maybe you might be getting sick. Some of you guys might not be eating right. Take care of yourself physically and emotionally. Eight of Swords is feeling like you're stuck, like you're stagnant, not looking at the situation clearly. The Hierophant is, you know, trying to figure out what traditional values, maybe you feel like things are not living up to your expectations. So there was an ending of something, a transformation of a separation of some kind, an ending of something. So there needs to be an ending of old ways, okay? So however you took these situations or the relationships you had in the past, or however your outlook of it, or your mindset of it was, you need to leave that in the past and rebuild yourself. However you acted in the past, leave it there. In the past, you need to start brand new, and this is fast movement, you know what I mean? Moving fast towards whatever it is that you want. I feel like a lot of you guys might be going out of town, or people might be coming out of town to see you, celebration, you know, going out, having a good time. Focus on yourself, don't be worried about what happened in the past. But I do have to say this, the way that you approach the situation, that is what you get in return. So try to work on how you approach whatever situation that you're looking for. Because if you don't approach it the correct way, that is one of the reasons why you're going to be disappointed. Three of Cups, Three of Pentacles. So the number three is going to be a significant number for you guys. It could be 3 weeks, 3 days, 3 years, 3 minutes, 3 hours, anything pertaining to the number three. Okay, there's a message of some kind coming your way. I feel like you don't know everything about this person. There's things that you don't know. There's hidden lies, hidden deception that you're not sure about. Family and friends are there. People will be there to support you no matter what. Collaborating with somebody is the biggest thing for you. Maybe you might see somebody you haven't seen in a while, and they're going to want to give you some type of advice and trying to tell you what the next step should be for you and how you need to react towards a certain situation, which isn't so bad. So don't be so negative towards the advice that somebody wants to give you. So take that advice and really work on yourself. So guys, hopefully you guys enjoyed this reading. So thanks you guys for watching, guys. Bye-bye.